Hi there. Today we're going to learn about the organisational levels of life, from the teeniest, tiniest level to the largest and most complex one. At present, we categorise the hierarchy into roughly 13 levels, and we do so because each of these levels is what makes up the one above it. From the smallest level, these are subatomic particles, atoms, molecules, organelles, cells, tissues, organs, organ systems, organisms, populations, communities, ecosystems, and biospheres. Have you ever considered how amazingly complex things can be built from simply building blocks? The Roman Colosseum, the Taj Mahal, and almost all of the great structures in the world have been built brick by brick, block by block. In much the same way, as complex as we are, we humans and every organism on Earth is constructed ultimately by the bricks of atoms. So, let's learn about atoms. Atoms are the basic building blocks of all life. They're tiny particles with a diameter of about 100 picometers. They're so small, in fact, that a single sheet of paper is around 500,000 atoms thick. But atoms aren't the smallest building blocks. Atoms themselves are composed of three major subatomic particles: protons, electrons, and neutrons. Protons and neutrons make up the nucleus of an atom, and electrons revolve around the nucleus. When atoms have different combinations of protons, neutrons, and electrons, they have different mass and charge, and therefore behave in different ways. Each of these combinations creates a different type of atom, and it's these atoms that go towards making everything else in the world. You'll likely have seen the periodic table of elements. This shows you all the different types of atoms. Many atom types are unstable, so they naturally react and combine with other atoms to create molecules. A simple molecule, like water, is composed of only two types of atoms, but molecules can be endlessly complex. Eventually, groups of molecules go together to form organelles, which are membrane-bound specialized structures. They exist within cells in order to perform specific functions. And these organelles combine in various ways to create cells. Cells are thought of as the smallest structural and functional element of a living being, and some organisms are unicellular, which means they are only one cell, while many others, like humans, are multicellular, which means they're composed of many cells working together. The step from unicellular life to multicellular life is a big one. Suddenly, so much more becomes possible. When living things are multicellular, cells are organized into specialized tissues that make up organs, like a lung, for example, and a group of various organs perform complex functions together as part of an organ system, like the respiratory system. An organism is the most complex organization of multiple organ systems, with each performing different bodily functions. It's all of these systems working in harmony that keep organisms alive. And now we're in the real world, at least the one that you experience when you turn off your computer. A human on their own is an individual organism, but when they inhabit the same location and time as other humans, they form part of a population. Scientifically speaking, it's almost impossible to live only amidst a single population. Humans share their spaces with all manner of other organisms: microbes, dust mites, insects, dogs, cats, birds, and so on. A collection of organism populations is known as a community, and a community lives within an ecosystem, which is all of the living and non-living elements combined in a system. Water, wind, rain, and ground, for example, aren't alive, but form part of the system in which we live. And much of the food we depend on itself depends on things like wind pollination. The Earth is made up of many different ecosystems that work in balance with and against each other. Similar ecosystems around the world are classified into biomes, which helps to signify the kinds of animals and plant life that exist within these biomes, and what kind of environmental conditions can be expected in each one. And altogether, these biomes become the biosphere, the entirety of the Earth's habitable space. One day soon, we may even be learning about other worlds' biospheres. So, here we have the big picture view, the whole world in a palm. but we should address a question that often confuses pupils. Why is the organisational hierarchy in multicellular beings, the whole big world, more complex compared to unicellular beings? And does this mean that complexity and evolution stops at the cellular point? Importantly, no. Unicellular beings, like bacteria, continue to evolve and participate very actively in their environments. It's why we have to constantly invent new vaccines for viruses, and why we get the flu every few years. It may be useful to consider that, on their scale, unicellular organisms are much the same as a single human or animal. They can interact with other animals, but they can't join with other animals. So they have to instead exist within their environment and try to survive. Multicellular organisms, on the other hand, are able to join together to make tissues, organs, and organ systems. The ability to join together into a coherent system essentially makes it possible to create entirely new environments at each scale. Unicellular life, then, is still varied and active, but stuck at the unicellular level in much the same way that individual human lives are stuck at an individual level. Perhaps there's another big step to come. But let's not get too distracted by science fiction and stick with the science. Life, in all its wonderful and terrifying forms, is defined and made up by the complex biological structures and hierarchies of various systems. Each of the levels in the hierarchy of life necessarily requires more organizational complexity. Each level becomes a new brick with which to build the next, more complex level. If it weren't for all these levels of organization, none of the world that we experience would exist. Homeostasis couldn't be obtained, metabolisms wouldn't work, and no organisms could function. And if that's a spooky thought, consider that you too can influence your environments. Hopefully for the better. See you next time.